Kenya has in the recent past been heavily reliant on debts to implement her infrastructure projects, which has elicited a lot of public debate that the country may be overburdened by debts it cannot repay. And with 90% of the projects run by the government, the just released report by Deloitte indicating that approximately 48% of projects are overbudgeted and 87% of them are overrun by time, leading to cost escalations, only adds to the fears that the country's debt could be getting out of hand.
If the borrowing is done wisely, you are delivering an asset that creates value to the economy, which generates revenue for the economy. One of the topical debates is, should people pay for services over and above their taxes? Should users pay? So if I'm driving on this road and someone that lives in another part of the country, should they pay for the road I'm driving on? So, which is quite a complex debate in terms of tolling. And so tolling is one of the tools that governments could use to repay back an asset, but it has a lot of political and social issues that need to be clearly understood.
Some of the projects that have been overrun by time is the construction of the Lake Turkana power line to evacuate the already available 318 megawatts, meaning that Kenyans could be paying for power that is not getting to them.
The delays in connecting the transmission line. So the plant was built by the private sector. They've signed effectively a power purchase agreement with government, so government will take the power at an agreed price. I think the issue that's coming now is the delay in connecting Lake Turkana to the national grid and for the country as a whole to benefit from that power.
According to Deloitte, it will be difficult for the country to achieve maximum economic benefits from the standard gauge railway line unless the country gets at least 40% of all freight services on the railway.
We're not aware of anywhere in the world that the volume or the revenue from passenger tickets can significantly pay back the capital borrowing. So hence there's always this implicit subsidy. However, if you're moving a lot of freight, there are many railway lines in the world that are freight dependent, and the volume of freight is sufficient to pay back the capital, the capex, and the opex, the operational costs. So a mix of freight and passenger is good, but the real money spinner is freight for railway lines.
And as much as involvement of the government infrastructure projects is needed, there's need to bring in the more effective private sector through public-private partnerships, as well as improvement of the current procurement procedures.
If government is funding 90%, it shows an active government, it shows a government that's involved, a government that's hopefully using taxpayer money wisely to develop the economy. But I often think there is a greater role for the private sector that could happen.
Nicholas Ndwati, News Hour Business.